Good morning and welcome to Bad at Arenas with Doc Stout. If you guys watched my last two arena run videos, you'll see that I didn't do so well, so I've decided to call this series Bad at Arenas in the hopes that you guys will watch me stream and I will get better, so at some point I'll have to change the title. Last time I went with Shaman, and we got three new choices for a fresh run. Druid, Priest, and Warlock. Usually, in my pursuit of being less terrible at this format, I try to get something that has a hero power that has a permanent impact on the board. Unfortunately, I don't have that option here. Druid gives you armor and allows you to attack for one. Priest allows you to heal yourself for two or heal a minion. And, of course, Warlock allows you to take some damage and draw cards. Since I've had so many people watch the Murlocs Invade Naxxramas video, and arenas seem intent on offering me Warlock, let's actually see if my preferred class has anything for me. So I'm going to try Warlock, see if we can build a deck here. First choice, Hungry Crab, Doomsayer, Twisting Nether. Kind of like a board wipe. I don't know about for eight, though. Actually, it looks like we have two board wipes, and then the Hungry Crab just eats Murlocs. That seems kind of against my philosophy with this game. Although a 1-2-4-1 is fine, even if I don't get any Murlocs. And Doomsayer is a 0-7. I actually think I'm going to take the Hungry Crab, despite it being practically against my religion. Yeah, worst case scenario, he's a 1-2-for-2, which is fine. Stone Singing Gargoyle. Fen Creeper's a 3-6 with Taunt for 5. That's just valuable. Wind Fury, 2-3-for-3. It's fine. Stone Skin Gargoyle is more situational. I think I clearly have to take the Creeper, though. Power Overwhelming allows me to suicide a guy, but give him +4/+4 until the end of the turn. That might be useful if I can get an Arubian Egg or something. 5-4/5. Taunter's good. Flame Imp's a 3-2/1 that deals me 3 damage. I like him in Constructed. Not sure how much I like him in Arena. So my two choices are here. This card will sometimes be dead, so I guess I'll just take another 5-drop Taunter. Hard Removal, Archmage, Sense Demons. I think the Hard Removal for 1 is the best. Wow, if I take a Voidwalker, I'm just taunt, taunt, taunt. Mortal Coil is theoretical card advantage. But I think Cult Master's card advantage plus a 4-2/4. That's fine. We've got enough Taunters. Silvermoon Guardian, Divine Shield, 3-3/4. I like the Wind Fury Harpy. It strikes twice, and it is a threat that must be answered. Then I have a 6-drop Taunter, an Elven Archer, or Golchar Footman. I don't actually like any of these, but I guess I'll just take the 6 power for 6. I've got more than enough taunt, but I need something at 3 drop. My choice is basically between the Grizzly and the Berserker. I guess I could go all in on a defense control style. Oasis Snapjaw's fine. 2-7/4. 3-3/3, and I get 3 health back. Although I think more removal is just good in Arena. Young Priestess is a 2-1/1 that gives more health to a guy. Yeah, I think that's probably my best option there. Dread Infernal is a 6-6/6 that deals 1 damage to everything else. Seems fine. I'm never going to get the upside on South Sea Deckhand. I don't think I need another Taunter for 1, so let's... So we've got the top of our curve sort of sorted. We've already got 2 5-drops. I love the Nightblade. get 7 potential damage out of him. Though I think I'm going to have to take a Fairy Dragon. I don't have any 2-drops, and a 3-2 for 2 is awesome. Now, this is an interesting choice, because Soulfire is 0 mana removal. It has a downside, I have to discard a card. And Demon Fire is potentially a buff, but I don't actually have any demons yet. So, I think of the two, because I'm not even considering the Gargoyle, I'm going to have to go with Soulfire. You can also go to the face. Hellfire is stock Warlock Board Wipe. Seems good. I have the Hungry Crab. So, a 2-1 for 2, or destroy your opponent's weapon, a 3-2 for 2. Man, as much as I'd like to get... Actually, the Frost Elemental's fine, too, if I didn't already have 3-6 drops. But I think my choice is between the other two. Much as I like the synergy with a Hungry Crab, that's marginal upside. I'll just take the 3 power and the possible upside of destroying a weapon if I get matched up against, like, Warrior or Rogue. Don't have enough demons for that to be relevant. I've passed on Silvermoon Guardians before. I always love silence effects. Do I have a Cult Master? I do. I think if I'm going to double up on anything, because I'm going to ignore the Voidwalker, it's probably going to be a Hellfire rather than a Cult Master. Do I have enough guys for Frostwolf Warlord? I think if I only have one guy, I'm pretty happy with getting value out of him. Plus, I have still a few cards. I could get one of the options that makes him truly sick. Speaking of, Imp Master has awesome synergy with the guy I just got, whose name escapes me, the Frostwolf Warlord. Imp Master, snap decision. All right, we've got legendaries. Stormrage, Jiraxxus, or Deathwing? I think in this deck, I'm going to have to say you are not prepared. Because Stormrage absolutely has to be answered. That's only if you play a card. Deathwing would be pretty sweet, too. 12-12 that destroys everything else. For 10. Jiraxxus is only available to Warlocks, but I don't actually like him very much. I mean, he allows me to attack for 3 every turn, and gives me 15 health, so it's good when you're behind. I'm actually going to try Deathwing, though. My instinct was to say Illidan. I've never played with Deathwing before, so I want to try him. Do I have enough creatures? Well, Elven Archer I don't think is what I want for creatures anyway, so I'll just take the creature removal. More removal, including can go to the face. I need creatures for, like, everything else. I guess I'll take a Venture Company Merc or a Dread Infernal. I already got enough high drops. Void Caller would get, at this point, a Dread Infernal. Oh, that's pretty sweet. I think I'll just take the Void Caller. I don't have very many Death Rattlers. Argent Squire's fine. I think I'm just going to take a River Crocolisk. I'm never excited to play one, but he's fine for 2. Of these guys, Iron Beak Owl is clearly the pick. Let's look at my curve. I don't have any hasters. I have some early drops. I have 3 at 5. 2 creatures at 4. I think I'll take the Spectral Knight. 4 more picks. Silverhand Knight, It's a 4-4 and he makes a 2-2. I need creatures. Young Priestess, I've already got one of. Sun Fury Protector could give me more taunters. It's also a 2-3 for 3. Felguard's fine. I don't want a Felguard being pulled out by the Void Caller, though. I know that's an edge case. How many 2-drops do I have? Not enough. I'll grab a Sun Fury Protector. Late game, he's still relevant. I think Unstable Ghoul is the clear pick here since I don't have a lot of 1-toughness creatures. Mana Addict could give me +2 attack every time I cast a spell. I have some of those. Or I could get the Death Lord. Yeah. I've got 2 taunters here. I think his downside is less severe than the Felguard's in some ways. Alright, well, that's my deck for Bad at Arenas. Let's see if I can be bad at playing it. I'm moderately happy with this deck. At least I have a legendary at the top. I don't know if I chose the right one, but let's find out. Give this a test run. Definitely a far cry from my typical aggro deck, where I just want to grind out card advantage and overwhelm somebody by turn 5. This is going to play a more late-game strategy with grindy removal and lots of taunters. Our first opponent is playing Jaina.
Jaina.
One of my favorites.
You asked for it.
Your soul shall be mine!
This opening hand seems absolutely awful. I think I'm going to throw the entire thing away. This is a little better. Fairy Dragon and some removal. Ah, nice. 1-drop off the top. I'll probably follow it up with a Fairy Dragon unless my top deck's awesome.
The light protects me.
I certainly don't want to silence him. He'll probably just kill it, but that's fine. We can grind out advantage a little bit at a time. I think he wants to make sure that his death rattle doesn't do anything. As predicted. For 3... I don't actually have much of anything to play. I don't know that a 2-1... I guess I'll draw a card. And pass turn.
My shield for Argus!
Alright. Now might be time to silence. So we got a 2-3 and a 1-1. I think I'll just take a little bit more damage and draw another card. We got a full grip now. Refusing to let me get value out of my Hellfire. That's fine.
Ready to ride.
Ugh. I'm gonna get aggroed out here. I need to slow this advance. Bum, 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 bum. Let's see, yeah. Play an Acidic Swamp Ooze. The upside doesn't matter. Just try and grind out card advantage, which is hard to do against the mage, and I still don't know what this is. Sure, that's fine.
I'm flying.
Yeah, I cannot allow that thing to keep cracking in on me. Seems bad. Keep taking damage. At this point, I got a 10-turn clock.
For the king!
Ugh.
Someday I'll be just like you!
As much as it's gonna hurt me, I have to Hellfire now. Alright, his secret is not Counterspell. I'm gonna take two. I don't have any guys I can play. This is ugly. That'd take me to three. Yeah, I'm in really bad shape here. I can't safely use my life tap.
My magic will tear you apart.
I guess.
My magic will tear you apart.
Shut up. Squelch somebody. As soon as they start repeating taunting. I'm probably dead already. Yep. That's it for this run. I don't even really feel like I made a whole lot of mistakes. Just drew all my 5 and 6 drops and got aggroed out. Alright. Well, if I was awesome at this game, the series would not be called Bad at Arenas. I will be taking another run with this deck tomorrow. Hopefully, see if I can squeak a couple of wins out of it, though. But thanks for tuning in to see me build the deck. And our first run was not so successful, but I'm happier with this than I was with the Shaman deck. So if you have any comments about my card evaluation, or if you noticed any huge play mistakes, go ahead and comment on YouTube. Frequently, the laptop is not working, so I'm not responding to Twitch chat, but usually I have the archives up a day after, up on the YouTube channel at DocStout076, and I will see everybody tomorrow. Thanks for watching. This is Doc Stout, signing out.